there everyone, welcome to Movie Studio Zen. My name's Derek. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to burn a simple DVD or Blu-ray disc directly from the Movie Studio timeline. So there are actually many different ways you can make DVDs and Blu-ray discs. The normal DVD would have a menu, and then you send it to DVD Architect and you burn it from there. Well, this method gets rid of all that. So this means there's no menu, no DVD Architect involved. We're just making the disc directly from Movie Studio, just a very simple plain disc. So let's get started. So the first thing I'm going to do on the welcome window here is select New. Now, for my method, I'm actually going to ignore selecting a template at the top here. But what I am going to do is name the project. And tick that box. And that means that we have some folders have been created for our project to live in. Click OK. Now I'm going to import my video. So I'm just doing any old random video here. So in version 13, when you import a video, this window should pop up. Do you want to set your project video properties to match this media? Always say yes. This is one of the most important steps of the entire tutorial. So if I go to the Project Media tab, click on top of the video, and here down the bottom, this is telling us the properties for this video clip. So it's 1920 by 1080 at 29.97 frames per second. So because we said yes to that little pop-up window, if I go into my project video properties, you can see that it's matched it exactly the same now. Now, the reason why I like this method is because it should give you much smoother playback in the preview window while you're editing. Okay, so if that little window before I opened up this one, the one that asked about matching the video properties, if that didn't open up, then while you're in the project properties window just here, select match media video settings. So press that, then navigate through your computer to and find the exact same video clip you imported into your project. Select it, and that will then match everything for you. Okay. While we've got this window open here, make sure that you set the full resolution rendering quality to best. By default, it's on good. That's crazy. Do best. Go to the audio tab. Make sure resample and stretch quality is also best. And click apply. Okay. So now you're going to spend hours and days and weeks making a masterpiece. Before you do burn the disc, always make sure you do one final save as. So go project, save as. Okay. So now we go to the burning of the DVD stage. So select make movie, burn it to DVD or Blu-ray disc. And the option we want for basic DVD is that first one there. So no menus, no DVD Architect involved. Click next. And here is the second most important step of the entire tutorial. Video format. So because we matched the video property settings, the media settings, all that, the program should automatically select the correct format for us. Okay. So in my situation here, my 1080p video at 29.97 frames per second, the program has said that 720x480x60i is the correct template, and that's right. So if, for example, my video, my original video had been shot at 25 frames per second, the program would have selected 720 times 576-50i, 16:9, okay? And if it had been 24 frames, it would have been 24p. The only other options, which are becoming more popular today, is if your video had been shot at 50 frames per second, it would have also selected -50i. And if your video was shot at 60 frames per second, it would have selected 60i. So the program should do that automatically for you, but it's good to know what's actually going on. So then put in a blank disk into your computer, and then click OK. And I'm not going to go any further because I don't want to burn this silly little thing, but it'll render the video, render the audio, go through a couple of little quick little windows, and then that's it. End of story. DVD has been created. So that type of DVD, when you pop it into your DVD player, it may automatically start playing, or you may have to press the play button, but there'll be no menu. Okay, so now let's move on to creating a simple Blu-ray disc. So we do the same process, make movie, burn it to DVD or Blu-ray disc. This time select the third option, Blu-ray disc. Just before I click next, something I should have mentioned right at the very beginning. If you want to burn full HD video, then you must create Blu-ray discs. DVDs only can burn to standard definition video. So if you want the clarity of your original videos, you must burn Blu-ray. That's what it's there for. Okay, so let's click next. And I'm just moving that out of the way so you can see the details here. So just leave it on the first option here. Now for Blu-ray, we have a few more options. So for Blu-ray, you can actually encode it to MPEG-2 or Sony AVC. Generally speaking, MPEG-2 will give you a high quality video, slightly high quality because it supports higher bit rates. So I'm going to select MPEG-2. Do some experiments and see what you like. Second option here. So it's automatically selected -60i, 25 megabits per second. That's pretty cool. But just be aware there are some other options there that I think that maximum quality there will work just nicely. Audio format, there's only one option. Keep it there. And the audio template, there's only one option there, so keep that there as well. If you'd put in any chapter points in your video, make sure that box is ticked. But if you don't have any chapter points, just turn that off. Keep that turned off. Pop a blank Blu-ray disc into your computer. Click OK. Then it will render the video, the audio, construct the disc, and then burn it to Blu-ray. And that's it. That's the end of the story. In the next tutorial, I will show you something a little bit more advanced, the next level up. So if you want to create discs with menus, I'll show you what to do. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Everybody,